Now that you're recording conversations, let's take a look at how you can navigate Zoom IQ for Sales from both the Zoom desktop application and the Zoom web portal, which is just a fancy term for the Zoom website. In a web browser, navigate to zoom.us and sign in to your Zoom account. Along the left navigation, expand Zoom IQ for Sales and select Dashboard. Here, you can see your upcoming conversations, any open deals you are associated with, your performance over a set time period as it relates to a few key metrics, indicators you have subscribed to, and finally, notifications from IQ for Sales. Looks like my team member Frank has added a comment about a recent conversation. Let's check it out. Here we can see an active deal with a fledgling paper company based in the Northeast United States. Before I play the recording, I'll get up to speed on what happened. The auto-generated summary is convenient to skim to get a quick overview of what was discussed. Looks like this call had a few attendees, most importantly, the regional manager, who is the key decision maker. At a glance, I can see when each person was speaking and can click to jump right to a specific moment. Along the right, I can see information about this deal as well as calculated scores for how engaged the external participants were and their overall sentiment. Zoom IQ also lists out next steps discussed during the meeting. But let's not forget the all-important callouts, also known as indicators. These indicators are configured by your organization to look for keywords and phrases mentioned in conversations. By clicking on an indicator, you'll immediately jump to the transcript where sections related to that indicator are highlighted. After seeing how this call unfolded, I think this would make a great example to show the team. I'll click to create a clip, give it a name, set in and out points, and click Create. Now I have just the segment I want, and I'll add it to a playlist for next week's sales meeting. This was just one conversation of many that my organization has analyzed using Zoom IQ for Sales. Under Conversations, I can see a running list of just my conversations or browse conversations happening elsewhere in the organization. Arguably, one of the best features of Zoom IQ would be playlists. Browse existing playlists created by others, filter to see just those playlists that you follow, or create your own. Under Deals, you can see all of the deals you have tracked in Zoom IQ for Sales, or browse all deals to see how the pipeline is shaping up. Analytics is a goldmine of insight, especially as you continue to add more conversational data to the mix. See where you rank compared to your peers regarding the sentiment score of your calls. See how often a specific indicator is mentioned in recorded conversations. Or just see who is utilizing Zoom IQ for Sales the most. Everything we just covered in the Zoom web portal is also available in the Zoom desktop application. Along the top, you should see the Zoom IQ icon. However, if you don't see it, it might be hiding under More if your window is particularly small. I plan on using Zoom IQ frequently, so I will click and drag to reorder the icons. To recap what we have covered, you now know how to access Zoom IQ for Sales from both the Zoom desktop application and the Zoom web portal. You know how to explore the deals and analytics sections, and you've seen what a recorded conversation looks like and how you can watch, comment on, and share it with team members. Now, you also saw that a sentiment score is calculated for each call with a customer. My sentiment about you making it to the end of this video is 100% love. Heart transition.